My name is Dr. Jon-Paul Pepper, and I'm an assistant professor at the Keck School of Medicine in the Department of Otolaryngology. I am a facial plastic surgeon with a specific interest in the treatment of facial nerve paralysis. I was ecstatic to be recruited to USC. I do have an interest in not only developing my clinical practice, but also performing impactful research. My academy is the American Academy of Facial Plastic and Reconstructive Surgery. It encompasses, you know, all of our professional efforts, including research. For the first time this year, they pooled resources to give a larger research award that would deliver funding over multiple years. It is designed to be significant startup research funding for a member of the academy, so a practicing clinician and surgeon in an area of their choosing. And so I owe the academy a lot of thanks. And there were fundraising efforts involved and a lot of donations from academy members that made the award possible. They wanted to plant the seed for foundational and impactful basic science research. And so I think they felt that my project was a good fit for that. And that's the collaboration that I have with Justin Ichida. And so, you know, the title of our proposal was engineering a nerve graft from induced pluripotent stem cells. And so we described for the academy that the plan was to use mature human fibroblasts that are obtained from a simple skin biopsy that can be used to derive an induced pluripotent stem cell. The prospect of going from a simple skin biopsy to a functional motor neuron is essentially within our grasp, and for someone who treats facial paralysis, that is very powerful technology. It's very important for us as clinicians to understand the process of how stem cell therapeutics are developed, how they may eventually reach the clinic, and the clinician cannot be a passive vehicle. We have to understand exactly what the benefits and drawbacks are of stem cell therapy. And I just saw that it was such a powerful technology that it was plain to me after a month of sitting on lab meetings that I had to do something formal to improve my background in stem cell biology to be a more effective researcher. It takes a little bit of humility, you know, coming in and going back into a master's class. But in all honesty, getting a master's in stem cell biology is a very unique opportunity. I think there will be many more people who might be in my position, junior faculty, who are expanding a research program and realize that this is something that offers them some wonderful insight. The MD world has to have a really big part in the translational application of stem cell therapeutics. I think it's just very important.